What if canids were as large as big cats? The dog family has been around for nearly 40 million years, with its members conquering the continents in stunning style. This is a testament to the resourcefulness, intelligence, and adaptability of these amazing animals, qualities that made man fall in love with them in the first place. However, there is a significant quality that canids in particular seem to lack compared to their traditional feline rivals: size. The following video discusses why wild canids are not as large as the big cats and what the landscape of the wild would look like if they were. Without further ado, let's get started. What are canids? Wild canids, also known as canines or wild dogs, are part of Canidae, a highly successful family of carnivora mammals. Our pet dogs also belong to this family tree and are offshoots of wild canines like wolves. The word canid is derived from the Latin canis, which means dog. Canids are characterized by their upright ears, elongated muzzles, and flesh-tearing teeth. Today, there are around 35 species of wild canines on Earth, spanning the continents and adapted to a multitude of environments, from the icy Arctic to the scorching Australian outback. While different species live, look, and behave differently, they do have a lot in common, including the aforementioned physical description and certain behaviors like sociability with each other. Other common traits are acute senses like smell and hearing, as well as advanced vocal and body communication. Additionally, all canines are accomplished hunters, but will not hesitate to scavenge easy pickings if luck smiles on them. How big do wild canids get? Canines in the wild range greatly in size. On one end of the spectrum is the desert-dwelling fennec fox, Vulpes zerda, perhaps the cutest face in the desolate Sahara. This miniature canid measures around 15 inches from nose to tail, with a body weight of 2 to 3 pounds. At this size, these little dogs' diet mainly consists of insects, lizards, rodents, birds, and eggs. On the opposite end of the canid range is the mighty gray wolf, Canis lupus. Hailing from North America, Europe, and Asia, the king of wild dogs can reach up to 6.5 feet in length, with a shoulder height of about 30 inches. The North American timber wolf, the largest subspecies of gray wolf, can weigh up to 146 pounds. The wolf's larger size and pack lifestyle allow it to take on much larger game than its tiny desert cousin, with elk, moose, and even bears on the menu. Other notable wild dog species on the larger side include the red wolf, Canis rufus, the African wild dog, Lycaon pictus, and the maned wolf, Chrysochion brachioris. The largest wild canid ever documented was Epicyon haydeni, a bone-crushing beast that dwarfed the impressive timber wolves of today. Epicyon boasted a shoulder height of over 3 feet and a weight of at least 165 pounds. After 3 million years of terrorizing the plains and forests of North America, this large dog went extinct 7 million years ago. Another extinct big dog was the dire wolf, Enocyon dyrus. Yes, Game of Thrones fans, dire wolves were real creatures, and they were awesome. These Ice Age wolves were a tad bigger than their gray descendants, with body weight averages of 150 pounds. How big do wild cats get? While large dog species like gray wolves are not to be, no pun, sniffed at, they simply do not belong in the same weight class as some of the larger cat species in the wild. The Siberian tiger, the largest subspecies of tiger and largest cat species overall, can weigh up to 1,025 pounds, close to 10 times the weight of a fully grown gray wolf. In practice, this means a single tiger can, and does, bring down the same level of big prey as a wolf pack. The lion is another apex predator that dwarfs any dog species, wild or domestic. Big males have shoulder heights of nearly 4 feet, with lengths of up to 10 feet. Weight ranges between 350 to nearly 600 pounds. Females are also bigger than any dog, with a maximum recorded weight of 400 pounds. This size and the lion's tendency to work together means they routinely kill enormous creatures like cape buffalo and giraffes. The jaguar, which is the largest cat in the New World, is also larger than the biggest wolves. Males can reach 320 pounds or more. This powerful cat, renowned for its prowess in the water, is an expert caiman killer in the Amazon. Additionally, there are mountain lions, leopards, cheetahs, and snow leopards, all of which generally outweigh the bigger wild dogs. Why are canids not as big? The simplest answer here is evolution and adaptation. It is simply not advantageous for wild dogs to be as large as the biggest cats, for a variety of reasons. The main reason is their respective hunting strategies. Big cats thrive because they have mastered the art of stalking and ambushing prey. A 600-pound Bengal tiger still possesses the finesse and subtlety of a house cat, which allows it to get really close to the highly sensitive deer and monkeys it hunts in the Indian jungles. A 600-pound dog would simply be too clumsy and loud to hunt this way. Even the cheetah, the most dog-like of all cats, relies on stalking to set up a strike range that gets the most out of its supreme speed. However, larger canids like wolves and African wild dogs have sacrificed bulk and finesse for another important attribute, endurance. Ask any fitness athlete, and they will tell you that size is the enemy of endurance. This is why marathon runners are generally skinnier than sprinters or bodybuilders. Big cats like lions, leopards, tigers, and cheetahs rely on short bursts of highly concentrated energy, hence the need to sneak up as close as possible before being discovered by potential victims. Wolves, jackals, and coyotes, for example, have little need for this strategy because their endurance essentially expands their strike range. While a cheetah has a higher top speed than any dog, it can only chase for a few hundred meters before tiring out in need of a recharge. Wolves and other large canids have been known to pursue prey at a steady pace for hours or even days, wearing potential victims down with sheer exhaustion. Another comparison is the respective strategies of a lion pride and a wild dog pack hunting antelope on the African savanna. Lions would typically lie and wait in the tall grass downwind of an antelope herd, while other pride members would purposely scare the antelope and herd them toward the ambush. In this strategy, the setup is usually a much longer process than the execution and kill. In contrast, wild dogs would begin an immediate chase of the entire herd, keeping pace for long enough to target weak individuals. Once a target is identified, they remain in hot pursuit, nipping at the antelope's heels until the animal is simply too fatigued to go on. Here, the execution is a much longer process than any setup. Another reason dogs aren't as big as big cats is tied to the animal's sociability. Apart from lions, wild cats are generally solitary creatures. They associate with other members of their species during mating or when rearing young. As such, to bring down larger game, big cats need their bulk and the strength that comes with it. Dogs are generally more social, living in pairs or packs. This allows for more collaboration during hunting, which reduces the need for individual bulk. Finally, a bulkier body has higher energy demands. Apart from compromising endurance, larger bodies would require canids to eat more, which would require more energy for hunting. Bigger bodies would also limit nutritional gains from carcasses left behind by other large predators like lions, tigers, and bears. In Africa, for example, some jackal pairs don't even bother hunting their own meals and simply follow lion prides around. When the big cats make a kill, the canids wait patiently alongside vultures and other scavengers. When the larger predators move on, the jackals move in and gorge their tiny bodies on the scraps. What if they were as big? If canids were as big as the largest cats, it would be a mixed bag at best. With compromised endurance and limited stalking prowess, canids would likely depend greatly on scavenging and poaching meals, much like spotted hyenas in Africa. They would hunt opportunistically, but not enough to sustain large numbers. However, limited numbers would, in turn, compromise their hunting strategies even further. It is highly likely that big dogs would face extinction from starvation. Most of their prey would be evolved to be on the lookout for sneaky cats or prepared for marathon chases, which would leave them in dangerous limbo. Black and brown bears, whose hunting skills are patchy at best, have adapted by being omnivorous, while hyenas have brutal jaws that allow them to live off bone marrow in lean times. While bears and hyenas are not canids, they likely occupy similar ecosystem roles to our hypothetical large dog. Scientists also agree that the aforementioned Episcyon haydeni succumbed to starvation when big cats emerged on the scene and out-hunted it. However, the small and more durable canids were able to adapt and live on to this day. Nowadays, the best place for any would-be large canid would be in human captivity or as a domestic animal.